Hello guys, Kryzarel again. At the end of our last video, we were just done adding the vertical layout group component to our tooltip object. So let's pick up where we left off by understanding how that component works. Looking once again at the Unity documentation, the vertical layout group component places its child layout elements on top of each other. But how does the vertical layout group actually work? Unfortunately, something that's not very well explained in the documentation are both of these options right here, child control size and child force expand. Child force expand, as the name implies, forces child objects to stretch to fill all the available space, whether it's horizontally or vertically. In our case, we definitely don't want our text objects to expand vertically, so let's just disable this. Child control size, however, is much less intuitive, but what it does is make each child object's rect transform be controlled by the size of their layout elements. So essentially, it's just like putting a content size fitter on every single child of the layout group. And we can't add content size fitter components to objects inside a layout group, because they both want control over the object's rect transform, and it results in a conflict, so that's why this option exists. For our case, and I would argue probably most cases, we definitely want both of these checkboxes ticked, because we want our objects to have exactly the size that they need to have, no more, no less. As you have surely noticed, our background image is completely out of place, because the vertical layout group took control over it. So let's take control back by adding a layout element component and ticking the box that says ignore layout. Now we can correctly reposition it again, and it will stay that way. Let's add some padding to the vertical layout group to move our text away from the edges, and let's add some spacing too. Once again, these values don't need to be anything fancy, you can just choose whatever you like. I happen to think these look good. I also want to align the name and slot texts to the center. So we only have one line of text here for our stats, but we do know our items can give us several stats. There's at least two ways that we can deal with that. We could add more text objects to our tooltip. In this case we would add 8, because that's how many stats our items can potentially have, but that would require us to edit our tooltips if we were ever to change the number of stats that our items can give. So I'm going to suggest a way that I believe is a little bit more flexible, which is to use a single text object. And because we enabled the child control size checkboxes, we can add further text to this single text box, and it will increase in size automatically to fit all the text that we put inside it. And we can increase the line spacing to simulate the behavior of having different text objects that are affected by the spacing on the layout group. But whether we use a single text object or several, we would still like our item tooltip to increase in size to accommodate all of the stats that we need. To do that, we select our item tooltip object and simply add a content size fitter component and change its vertical fit to preferred size. We know from reading the content size fitter manual page that a layout group is also a layout element, and it calculates its size by adding together the sizes of all its child layout elements and also taking into account the spacing. So by adding a content size fitter and changing any of its variables to preferred size, we force the object with the layout group to have a size that can fit all of its child layout elements. On this object, I won't mess with the horizontal fit because I prefer it to have a constant width of 450. So with a content size fitter, the tooltip is already adapting to fit however many stats we need. However, if we remove enough stats, it starts getting way too small. So in order to fix that, we can just add a layout element component to the tooltip object and set a minimum height of, I'm going to say, 280. Once again, you can set this value to whatever you think looks good. So by editing only the minimum height, we still allow the object to grow in size to fit all of its children, but its height will never go lower than this. Now that we have a layout element, an alternative setup to leaving the horizontal fit on the content size fitter to unconstrained would be to set it to either minimum size or preferred size, and then overriding the corresponding value in the layout element component. so there's two last things that I'd like to do to consider this tooltip complete. The first one is disable the raycast target option from all of our text objects. We definitely don't need to detect any mouse clicks, or any mouse input for that matter, in these objects, so let's not waste processing power on that. On the background image, we might want to leave it checked. I'm still not sure if we want to let clicks go through the tooltip or not. The other thing I'd like to address is the stretching of the background image. If we increase the size of our tooltip enough, we can see that the background image starts to stretch in very weird ways. To fix this, we need to change the image type from simple to sliced, and now Unity is going to rightly tell us that this image doesn't have a border, so we need to come down to our project folders, select our image, and under the inspector window, we need to click the sprite editor button. In here we can configure our borders by dragging these green lines around, or by manually setting the values in this sprite window. I can already tell you that a value of 70 on all sides works really well for this image. This is telling Unity to keep the edges of the image intact and repeat or stretch the middle section to fill the remaining space. For more in-depth knowledge of how this works, I'm gonna leave a link in the description about 9 sliced sprites. When we're done setting our borders, don't forget to hit the apply button in the top right corner. Uh-oh, but now our borders look really big. What can we do to fix this? If we mouse over this pixels per unit variable, it tells us how many pixels in the sprite correspond to one unit in the world. So basically, by increasing this, our sprite will look smaller. I think a value of 300 looks very good for this. Let's hit apply, and voila! We have a tooltip that looks good no matter how big it gets, or no matter how small it gets, and it can fit every single thing that we want to fit inside it. That's what she said. So let's set up the stat tooltip. For this tooltip, I just made a copy of the item tooltip and changed some values around. I changed the names of some objects and their default texts, but most importantly, we need to change the yellow text to read modifiers, and we need to align all three texts to the left. The idea here is that in code, we will use the first text to display the name of the stat, its final value, the base value, and the value added by the modifiers. We will not change the yellow text, and the modifiers text will have the list of all the modifiers that have been applied and their source. This is it for today, guys. I hope you have enjoyed, and see you next time.